Seven Dust and Trevante merchandise group. July 1st in the U.S. tour in September. Support on travel. Come home. Lydia can't bring tickets going until this Friday, June 18th. The organizers of the Long Rail Whack and Roll Festival have been known as Bullhead City, a mini edition of the world famous heavy metal event set to take place September 16 to 18 in Whack in Germany. The festival features several stages, including the main stage on Bullhead City Plaza. German Metal's Obscura will release a new LA Valedication, the Fermer 19 Nuclear Blast, on 2018's delivery and sees the band. A new era of extreme metal is a combined much of a songwriting with surprisingly catchy melodies and stunning craftsmanship. A validation was mixed and mastered by award-winning producer Philip Nordstrom. Human scum, have you received your 5G chip implant? You need a vaccine yet? Now that we've gotten your shot in the arm, Gorn will give you a shot in the mouth of spew. This fall has returned to the real North America, the first part of Scumbag's 30th anniversary tour. Now if you're asking yourself, why is the band Soundgarden? Since the passing of Chris Cornell, still ongoing. it really kind of just like sickens, worries me ever since, and I mean it's the utmost respect for the late great Chris Cornell, but to have Chris's, you know, widow Vicky, and still with his ongoing, you know, recollection of Chris Cornell's assets with the band Soundgarden, according to, you know, the widow and personal representative of the estate of band's lead singer Chris Cornell, have announced that effective June 15th, they have come with a temporary agreement to challenge for Soundgarden's social media accounts and website, and the band members came to Matt Caron and their managers. According to Vicky Cornell and Soundgarden, effective June 15th, they come to a temporary agreement that will transfer to Soundgarden social media accounts and website to the band's remaining members, Kim Tom, Matt Caron, Ben Shepard, and their managers. Red Light managers include Soundgarden's website, Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter. Their agreement may make a productive first step towards healing and open dialogue and requires which for social media accounts to celebrate the band's accomplishments and musical continue to honor Chris's legacy. Vicky added in a separate statement for our joint social media efforts, temporary agreement with my family and love was friend of the Soundgarden hopes to celebrate Chris's music. I'll be mutual respect and love will recognize the profound pain caused by Chris's tragic loss in the past will take us down. This past March, Style, Cameron, Shepard, and their business manager, Vinarissa's Paul Papers in Washington State, U.S. Senator Clean of Vicky Cornell, has locked them out of all their social media accounts, as well as Soundgarden's official website, changing all their passwords. Style, Cameron, Shepard, Clean, their socials were previously managed by the management company of Patriot Management. They said that they learned that Patriot handed over all their social media accounts to Vicky after Patriot was terminated in October 2019. The band asked a judge to order Vicky Cornell to hand over the passwords to clue the final postings. The Soundgarden simply suspended social media accounts due to the pending litigation. Earlier today, Dial Cameron have posted their first best since regaining control of their Soundgarden accounts. Hey Soundgarden fans found our site is intended to celebrate music team's career and legacy of the band, along with news information about current and future plans, including regular solo work. We encourage your fans to share their comments, praise, and criticism. We don't expect to be appropriate, courteous, and respectful to each other. And we are super stoked to have our socials return to discussions and posts about being in the ring and great rock band, remember the guitars, drums, vocals, volume, more comments about what I show on X's. The whole nine yards. I mean, our former band members get it. School sending to the outs in the room, there weren't being any threat, bullying, mocking, any kind of director to anyone. I've heard more. Don't post discussions of insane experience theories, cast blaming our Chris Grimm, anyone comments or we more the character caliber of the fans who support our growing us all the years, geez, and decades keep us proud. Peace, love to our brothers and sisters, Exo Sanger. The one thing that just irks me, that Chris Cornell's widow, Vicky, that she wants everything that Soundgarden's been working on up until the passing of Chris Cornell. According to Vicky's lawsuit, Kim Thayil, Ben Shepherd, and Matt Camp claim they don't have possession of their own creative work. Alleged Vicky has possession of only existing multi-track recordings of the last Soundgarden tracks, Chris Cornell's instrumental parts and vocals. All the band members only work on those final works. Vicky now claims ownership. Really, Vicky Cornell? You're owning Soundgarden's work? I just, the light of me. Anti-vaccine, this is still one of the music guidelines in case you're watching. Anti-vaccine protesters demonstrate outside Foo Fighters concert over because California allowed only vaccinated fans. The Dave Grohl front elephant formed at the Canyon Club on Tuesday as a warm-up gig for Foo Fighters appearance in Madison Square Garden in New York City. In 1995, Bullocks from Newcastle called the Screaming Jets took the Australian music scene by the scruff of their neck and gave a red hot shake for the first time their first work deal with recordings. Screaming Jets overclocked on more than 200 live shows. Access TV reportedly announced the series, although which was, If These Walls Could Talk, debuting on Wednesday, July 7th. Emerging in the late 2019, PSSR, the new New York-based Alpha Future Guns N' Roses drummer Frank Ferrer released the debut single Busted, Future guest appearance with Guns N' Roses guitarist Richard Forrest. This was followed by two equally New York rocker tracks, Last Time and Push.